Okay, students, now the next topic which we are doing, that is Holy Prophet's behavior towards others. The Holy Prophet, he was very polite, gentle towards everyone, and he always treated everyone with kindness and tenderness, and he never showed harshness to even to his enemies. Now we are going to see that how was his behavior towards his own companions, his friends, the Sahaba Karam who used to be with him. The Holy Prophet, he was the Holy Prophet's mercy, his kindness and concern for his companions was widely known, and he used to inquire about the welfare of each one of his companions. He would get worried if any one of them did not visit him for a couple of days. He took interest in their welfare as well as personal problem, and he always tried to solve that. He shared their joys and sorrows and was never indifferent to any one of them. It means that he did not differentiate any of them. It was due to his kindness that he was always surrounded by his devoted followers who would not hesitate to sacrifice their lives for him. They played a significant role in his successful political struggle. Definitely, the Prophet, peace be upon him, he could not complete or accomplish his mission unless he had the support, he had the help of his companions. So that's why his behavior towards his companions, it was very polite and gentle, and he was very very concerned about their issues as well. The Prophet's behavior towards children, Muhammad, peace be upon him, he was always very kind towards children. Not only his own children, but the Holy Prophet used to show great affection to the children of others. Whenever he would come across a child, he would show his affection and make dua for the child. The Holy Prophet, he loved the children very much. There are many examples from his life in which we can see that the Prophet, he showed his love, his tenderness, his respect, even respect for children. Once Anas, a Holy Prophet's companion, he said that Holy Prophet would make prayer brief if he would hear a baby crying. And the Holy Prophet not only loved Muslim children, this is very important to know for all of us, that the Holy Prophet, he never showed love only for Muslim children. Once in a battle, few children came into a battlefield and were killed. Holy Prophet was distressed. Someone came and told him that they were children of disbelievers. He replied, even children of unbelievers are better than you. Beware, do not kill children. See, this is the teaching of Islam which gives at the time of war. That if during the war you find children, so you should not kill them. When anyone brings first fruit of the season, he would give it to youngest child in the family. After the migration from Makkah, as he was entering Medina, some young girls of Ansar were singing with joy in front of their houses. The Prophet, he asked them if they loved him, and they answered in affirmative. To this, Holy Prophet said, I love you too. Move on to the next slide, please. Well, we all remember that in the time of Jahiliya, or the ignorant period, which is known as the period of ignorance, what was the status of women? They were not given rights. They were not having a right to get education. So the women at that time, they were considered as insult. But when the Islam reached, when the Prophet, he spread Islam, he brought the teaching of Islam, in which the status of women, it was raised. The Holy Prophet, he was very kind to the women who were very harshly treated in those days. He gave them honor and dignity. Holy Prophet aside day for women to listen to him and to ask questions. A particular day was assigned for the women that they will come and they can ask their questions directly from the Prophet, peace be upon him. Once Holy Prophet was sleeping in the house of Hazrat Aisha, It was day of Eid and the girls were singing. Abu Bakr came and told them to stop singing. The Holy Prophet said, let them sing, it is the day of Eid. As a result of the Prophet's kind treatment, women would visit and ask him different questions, whatever they wanted to ask. Companions were surprised of their boldness. The Holy Prophet was always gentle and tolerant towards them. So this was the reason that the Prophet, he always welcomed them, he always respected them and treated them with dignity and honor. So the women, they were not hesitant to go to the Prophet and ask the questions or to resolve their issues or whatever the problems they had. They could easily go and talk to the Prophet, peace be upon him, just because the Prophet, he always treated them with generosity and with honor. Behavior towards poor and orphans. We have learned the quality of the Prophet, that he was very humble, very kind to everyone. So he always showed his kindness towards poor and orphans as well. He used to be with them in Kaaba for prayers. He never showed arrogance. He never showed pride. He was always with the poor, and never felt any kind of hesitation or felt insult that he is among poor. Once a companion was sitting in mosque of Prophet and poor were sitting on other side. Holy Prophet came and sat with them, and then the companions also went and sat with them. The Prophet said, give good news to the poor Muhajirin that they will enter paradise 40 years before the rich. Their face lighted up with joy and happiness. So it was the glad tidings for the poor, that they are poor here, or they are not as blessed, they are not blessed here with wealth or with the respect, but this is the glad tidings for them, that news, good news for them, that they will enter paradise 40 years before the rich. Abu Dharr, another companion, said that the Holy Prophet ordered him to love the poor and be near them. So students, this lesson is not only for Abu Dharr or for the companions of the Prophet. This lesson is for you, for me, for everyone, that we have to show love towards poor and always try to help them. Moreover, the Holy Prophet advised people to treat the poor and the destitute with kindness. He issued instructions that zakat should be collected from rich of every tribe and town and should be given to poor of same tribe and town. Holy Prophet was also kind to orphans, as we know that he himself was an orphan, so he better knew that how, what are the feelings of an orphan child and what are the requirements of an orphan. So he was always kind to orphans and told his companions to treat them with kindness and love. Holy Prophet is reported to have said, anyone who treats well an orphan girl or boy under his care, he and I shall be like these two in paradise. And then he showed his two of his fingers together. Treatment of slaves. The Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, he was particularly kind to slaves. He used to say, they are your brothers, give them to eat what you eat, give them to wear what you wear. Whenever the Prophet, he received any slaves, we remember that the slaves, they used to come after conquering the battle, after any battle, the slaves, they were, many the people of other party, they were brought as captives. So these captives became slaves. So whenever he received any slaves, he always freed them, but they would never leave him. Zaid bin Haris, he was a slave. The Holy Prophet, he freed him and gave him the choice to go with his father, who had come to take him, but he refused to go and preferred to stay with the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. Once a companion abused a slave who complained to the Holy Prophet. He said to his companion,
You are still ignorant. These slaves are your brothers. God has given you power over them. If they are not suited to your temperament, sell them. Don't harm God's creatures. So what do we understand and what do we learn from this topic, the treatment of the Prophet, peace be upon him, with his slaves? That we have to be very, very careful while dealing with our mates, with our servants. If we do not like their work, if we do not want them to continue with in our house, so we should not treat them harshly. It's better to ask them to leave the job and we can hire a new one. It is reported by Hazrat Abu Bakr that the Holy Prophet, he said, one who treats his slaves badly and unkindly will not enter paradise. Move on to the next slide, please.
The Holy Prophet always treated his enemies with compassion and taught his companions to do likewise. It is reported that when he was a non-believer, Abu Basr al-Ghafari, that when he was a non-believer, he came to Medina and stayed as a guest of the Messenger of Allah. He drank milk from all his goats at night, but the Prophet did not say a word. That night, he and all his family members slept humbly. Abu Huraira's mother, who lived with him in Medina, was a non-believer. She used to abuse the Holy Prophet, about which Abu Huraira complained. But the Prophet, he prayed for her. He did not say or he did not curse his mother. Instead, he prayed for her. This was his treatment towards enemies and unbelievers. The Prophet, peace be upon him, he did not teach us only the rights of people, but he guided us how to treat animals as well. He was very kind to animals. The Arabs were very cruel to them. It was common practice in Arabia to put a ring around the neck of the camel. This practice was stopped by the command of the Prophet, peace be upon him. He also forbade people to keep animals in their works for the long time. Animal fights were also stopped. The Holy Prophet said that to brand animals on those parts which were not tender. Anas reported that he saw Holy Prophet branding sheep on their ears. This was the custom of Arab people, that they used to stamp the animal. So the Prophet, he that is known as brand animals, to brand the animals or to stamp the animals. So the Prophet, he asked them to stamp on those parts which were not tender. He was so kind and gentle to animals that he advised his companions to be considerate even at the time of slaughtering. He also advised them to slaughter them with sharpest weapon, so the suffering to the animal and pain is minimum. We all know that the Prophet, he has guided us at the time of slaughtering animals. There are few rules which we have to follow to sharp the weapon. One animal should not be slaughtered in front of other animals. So these are the rights of animals which are taught by the Prophet, peace be upon him, to the Muslims.